In a faraway galaxy lies a sun orbited by three planets, the Garal system. A place inhabited by humans and their creations, castes, numens, and beasts. For 500 years, there was war among the races, a seemingly never-ending conflict. Then finally, an era of peace and prosperity that has lasted 100 years. But now, a darkness has awoken and threatens the universe.
Rise and shine! Master Waber, it's time to wake up!
Ha! Who the heck are you?
Good morning, Master Waber! I am GHX-005. As of today, I have the honor of being in your service. Let me be the first to congratulate you on graduating from training school.
Oh, thanks!
Master Waber, if you do not get ready soon, you'll be late for orientation.
I know. Let me at least wash my face, okay?
I am GHX-005, Master.
Now how am I supposed to remember that? I know. From now on, I'm calling you Pete.
Pete?
That's right, Pete. It's the name of an old pet I used to have.
Understood. I shall be known as Pete, Master Waber.
Please, just call me Ethan, all right?
Your only appointment for today is the Guardian's orientation!
Oh. Yeah. That's great, except I just got here and I barely know which way is up. Wanna clue me in?
Thank you.
All right. I've never seen the horizon before. Yeah.
We will soon be passing over the abandoned city Melvor. 18 years ago, an explosion completely destroyed the city. The cause of this powerful explosion was never discovered. The ruins now serve as a memorial for those who once resided there. We will be arriving in Holtus City momentarily. We hope you enjoy your stay.
Thank you. I'd know we were meant to be together.
That's nice, but this isn't the right time.
Just one kiss? That's all I'm asking for?
Please, not now. My boss might catch me.
Sorry to bother you while you're busy. Ahem. You think I could get a Koltova juice? That's okay.
Of course. I'm so sorry, sir. I'll go get one right away.
Tactless as usual, huh, Ethan?
Is there any woman you don't try to pick up on? Try thinking with your head, Hugo.
I believe there's a spiritual bond between the sexes. And if the holy light brings us all together, well, who am I to fight it?
Why do I even bother talking to you? But just so you know, I'm supposed to meet my new partner here any minute now. And, rumor has it, my partner here is a girl.
What a coincidence! I'm waiting for my partner here as well. Please, try not to speak. Puts a damper on the conversation.
You two look like my guardian trainees.
An unexpected pleasure. I thank the Holy Light for this encounter.
What? I told you! She's my partner!
My name is Karen Arrow. I will be instructor and partner to both of you.
Both of... us?
Wait, that means...
He's my partner?
We normally have two-person teams, but we're short-handed now, so it has to be this way. I hope you both understand. I've been observing both of you for a while. You might be interested in my findings. Hugo Wright. Engaging in personal affairs while on duty is grounds for reprisal.
Yes.
And you, Ethan Waber.
Yes, ma'am.
I've been watching you since you've been on the colony, and your actions are too reckless. It's one thing to rely on yourself, but another to rely only on yourself. That's just foolish.
Wait, the colony? Hey, are you that girl that I saw?
While on duty, I expect you to use your head and think before you act.
Fine.
Even though you're only trainees, you have the same responsibilities as full-fledged guardians. One wrong move can cost you your life. The life of a guardian is a dangerous one. Now, gather up your things and get ready to move out.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Welcome, can I help you? Please come again.
Hey there, you want something? Thanks.
What's that?
It looks like a cargo transporter. It looks like the engine's still running, but I don't see the driver around here anywhere.
Check it out! Hey, what is this ugly thing?
Ethan, you really don't know what that is?
Not a clue. So what is it?
It's a Coltova.
That's a Coltova? I drink the juice from something that ugly?
What planet are you from? Don't you know the uglier the Coltova, the more succulent its meat is?
Hmm. Well, then you are one juicy Coltova.
Sorry, are you guardians?
That's right. Are you a resident here?
Oh, thank goodness you're here. I'm Norfe, the caretaker of this green farm. Since the seed attack, the Coltovas have been strange.
Strangely?
Yes, they've become very edgy and aggressive. When they attacked, we hid in a cargo container. But I don't know where Kalam is. Now he's gone! I've been looking everywhere!
Try to calm down. Now, who is Kalam?
He's Mr. Rimeson, the farm's owner. You see, I was hired to help around the farm. But Mr. Rime was killed during the seed attacks. Kalam and I have been protecting the farm ever since. If anything were to happen, Kalam, I don't know what to do.
Don't worry. We'll do everything we can. We'll keep an eye out for him. I'm sure he'll turn up.
Thank you for your kindness. Thank you.
Thank you. This is unbelievable. The seed did all this?
No. This wasn't the work of the seed. Those burn marks came from Alliance weapons.
What do you mean?
This Koltova. It doesn't look like it was infected. Look, here, see? No, it was killed by a weapon blast.
To prevent a second wave of contamination. All wildlife in the area have been terminated.
But this... barbaric.
What is it?
An Alliance tank.
This area is off limits. It is under quarantine. Identify yourselves immediately.
We are Guardians. Here on a purification mission.
I am the commanding officer of the 177th Brigade, Fulien Kurtz. Can't you see that this zone is being sterilized? There's no need for purification.
Yes, but we have a report of a missing child in the area. Have you seen a little boy?
I didn't know that the Guardians also offered babysitting services. You better find him quick, or hope that he's flame retardant.
Aren't you our allies? There's a kid in danger out there. Don't you care if he lives or dies?
I will not endanger the entire planet for the sake of a single child. The contamination must be stopped at all costs.
Why, you!
Remember what I said. I apologize for my comrade. Is it possible to delay sterilization until after we found the child?
Contamination has already begun to spread up ahead. And we anticipate another attack.
Leave the responsibility of the contamination to us.
Very well. However, if you find yourself in danger, send up a flare. We will provide help if we can.
Thank you for your cooperation. Let's go.
Novices.
Oh no, the seed.
That one's odd. Never seen it before.
The contamination is spreading too quickly. It's replicating like a virus. We don't have any time to lose. Let's get moving!
Yes, ma'am.
just might be my ideal partner.
Thank you.
That looks like the Alpha Seed over there.
So, we gotta purify it, right?
Yes, as long as there are no surprises.
Wow. What is that?
It's a relic site.
Relics?
They are ancient ruins that are thousands of years old, found scattered throughout the Goral system. It appears that the seed are often found near relic sites.
I've never seen one in person before.
There is still so much we can learn from them. This may require further investigation. We'll contact headquarters about it later. For now, we have a job to finish.
Yes, ma'am. Come on, Ethan, keep with the program.
Oh, yeah, yeah, hey, wait up! Oh no, what is that?
Is that Koltova? How did it get so big?
It looks like it's mutated from all the contamination. Be careful!
Thank you.
at all. You show real...
Man, that was pretty tough.
Stop it! Get away from my dad's Coltova!
Your dad's? That thing over there is from your farm?
Can't you see? It's got our farm's brand on its horn! This is my dad's Coltova, okay? So leave us alone! Go on and get out of here!
Hey, watch out, kid!
Let me do it! Let me go!
It's still alive!
Here, look after him! Here! I think.
You reckless fool. What were you thinking? Kalam!
Look, someone's glad to see you.
I can't thank you enough for this.
Oh, don't worry about it. It was nothing.
Didn't look like nothing to me.
Huh.
It's dangerous to wander off like that. I was so worried.
I promised my dad that I'd protect his Coltovas, but that's something a cast would never understand.
No!
Kalam!
Hey, Kalam, wait!
You might need some help there, Ethan.
Kalam... It was foolish of me to think I could take the place of his parents. But I don't know what to do now.
You know, I lost my parents when I was about the same age, too. At the time, I felt like I was all alone in the world. It was almost too much to bear. But with the help of people who supported me, I was finally able to get on with my life. Kalam's sad and alone. He doesn't know how to deal with it. He's pushing you away because he's confused and angry. Kalam needs someone who loves him. It doesn't matter whether you're a cast or not. What matters is making sure Kalam knows he's not alone.
Let me go! What are you doing? Let go of me, stupid!
But I promised Mr. Ryan that... I promised your dad I'd look after you.
I could get used to this. Helping people out, putting things right. Which reminds me, ma'am, I was wondering what you said to Norfe back there.
Nothing that concerns you.
Okay.
So, when did you join the Guardians, ma'am?
This is my third year. I got my license when I was 14.
Huh? What? Let me see. You're the same age as us? You're only 17?
That's right. So I guess you can call me Karen from now on. But don't expect me to make it any easier just because we're all the same age. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Tomorrow, let my soul stay. Ethan and his companions, together with the archaeologist Dr. Dorson, head to the relics, only to find a Daragon's nest. What terrible secrets do the relics hold? And what does Dr. Dorson know? And who is the mystery man that reveals himself? Next time on Phantasy Star Universe, Relics.